Hey, what's up, brothers and sisters in the body of Christ? I just wanted to make this video right quick, just to share with you the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ in a better way, how to explain it. Amen. And I guess y'all wondering why are y'all looking at a quarter on the floor? Well, I'm about to go explain that right now. Well, because I'm using these brown pennies represents men in their sins, okay? And these four coins, well, y'all see, I'm explaining the whole thing, okay? So I pray that y'all will listen very carefully, and this is for those who are not saved. These are for the people that wants Jesus Christ into their life and that wants to change. Amen, amen, in Jesus' name. So enjoy. Here we go. The Bible says that in the beginning, right, God already existed, right? We know that Jesus Christ is God, okay? Amen? He was sitting on the throne already in heaven already. He has no end, right? The Bible says he has no end, right? He's the beginning and he's the end, the Alpha and Omega, okay? He himself already existed in the beginning, right? Nobody created him. He existed in the beginning, okay? So the Bible also says that God created the heavens and the earth. Right, he created this big globe, right, which is called Earth that we live in now, right? It was peaceful. He created everything. It was loving. He created the animals. He created the fishes. He created everything that he loved, right? And the Bible says that everything he saw, it was good, right? And it says that he also created man, right, which is Adam and Eve, right? He created man and woman, right? Amen? Man should be with women, and women should be with men, right? But he created these two. Even though it's only one dime, but this represents man, period, right? So the Bible says that said that Adam and Eve, they walked with God, right? Every day they walked with him, right? He showed them everything around him, showed them how to name the animals, everything. They lived in perfect harmony with the Lord. They lived in perfect love with the Lord Jesus, amen? Until one day, man decided to separate themselves from God by doing what God told them not to do, right? Which they ate from the forbidden tree of good and evil, right? The knowledge of the tree of good and evil. Because they listened to what Satan said, right? And so when they did that, that's when sin separated man, right? So I'm using my mask right here. So sin separated man, right? This is sin. This is God. This is man, right? So man's heart started to turn dark. So he made a wall where Adam and Eve cannot go through the garden because sin separated man from God, okay? So it's hard for man to reach God because sin is in the way, right? But as sin continued to grow, man's hearts became darkened, starting to commit a lot of sin, a lot of it. Man started to grow wicked in the world, right? This is why he sent Noah to build an ark, because man's heart grew wicked, right? It grew wicked. And so Noah was found favor in God's eyes. God told Noah to build an ark, which he did, right? To warn the rest of the people. They didn't want to listen, so they died in the flood, right? And while Noah and his family, they were saved in the ark, right? So as sin was still in the world, right? Sin was still in the world. People still want to rebel and go against God, right? God sent his prophet. God sent his teachers, but they still didn't want to listen to warn Israel. Israel was still in darkness, right? So what God decided to do one day, he decided to leave his throne, right? And to come in the likeness of sinful flesh, right? He was born of a virgin. He came down as Jesus Christ, right? God manifesting in the flesh. Man, so just notice, people. Jesus Christ is 100% God, and he's 100% man, right? He's 100% God, he's 100% man. So Jesus Christ came down into the world to preach the gospel to those who were lost. Remember, he said in the word, he said that I came not for the righteous, but sinners to repentance, right? He came to preach the kingdom of God, of repentance. He came to tell people to repent that hell is real, okay? Because he created for the devil and his angels, but people still in their sins, right? But some people, so he went out and did a lot of miracles, casting out devils, raising the dead, okay? He started doing all these miracles. But some people in the crowd didn't believe him, and some people in the crowd believed him. They followed him, right? So So one day, Jesus is taken. As he was praying in the garden, he was taken. He was arrested. And he was tortured. He was beat. And then he went to the cross and died for the sins of the world. And then he was taken down from the cross. And he was placed in a man's tomb. So let's say this garbage can right here, this is the man's tomb, right? So he was placed in the man's tomb, right? The Bible says that 3 days and three nights, right? He said after Jesus Christ died, he ascended unto hell, right? To take the keys from Satan, right? So after 3 days later, to set the captives free too, as well, too, those people died in the flesh. Satan went down there and set them free, right? That when he rose again, that their body, that they also rose up, right? To manifest themselves in Jerusalem. But after 3 days later, Jesus Christ came back with all power in his hands. And then he went to his disciples. He met them on the Mount of Olives. He told them to go out into the world to preach the gospel, right? They that believe in his baptism shall be saved, and they that believe not shall be condemned. Okay, and that these signs will follow those that believe in their name. They shall cast out demons, they shall heal the sick, and they shall raise the dead, and they shall cleanse the lepers, right? And if they drink any deadly thing or eat it, it shall not harm them. And so he gave them the great commission to go out to make disciples. And then as he left them, he went back up to heaven, and he was seated back on his throne as God, right? So let's move it forward. Let's move it forward, right? Until the future, right? So this 2020, right? People are still living in, some people are still living in sin, right? That's why it's important for when a person is in sin, for them, if they understand what Jesus, who Jesus Christ is and what he did, and that they know he did, that he's God and that he died on the cross for their sins, and that God raised him from the dead on the third day. Once they believe that and they ask Jesus Christ to come into their heart, into their life, and he will come into their life, because he said in Revelation, he said, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. And if any man opens the door, if any man hears my voice, open the door, I will come into him," right? But that's not where it stops at, because there's a false teaching out there that goes out and say that, oh, if you confess your sins, the Lord Jesus Christ come into your heart, and then that sin, you are saved. No, there's more to it. Once you understand that, once you understand fully who Jesus Christ is and what he did, and you accept him as Lord in your life, the next step is baptism. Okay, baptism is the way of putting off the old man. The old man is sin, right? The new man is the new creation of you, okay? The new creation of you, right? The new you, okay? You make a change in your life to live for Jesus Christ, not for yourself anymore, because you're no longer in sin. So when a person, once they get baptized, once they go up under that water, they die, okay? They die with Christ. Just as Christ died on the cross and he was buried, same thing. Once they go up under that water, they die with Christ, and they're buried with Christ, and then when they come out of that water, they're raised to new life. They're clean in their spirit, right? Because the Bible said that the flesh is going to constantly try to sin against the Lord. But we, as we are newborn again believers, right, our spirit, right, it becomes clean. It becomes clean with the Lord, right? So we have that intimacy with the Lord Jesus Christ again. Amen. So that's when we come to prayer. That's why the Bible says that when we need God in time of need, then we got to come before the throne of grace boldly, right? So we live for Jesus, right? So once you become the new creation, the Holy Spirit comes and lives inside of you. God's Spirit will come and live inside of you. And you and him, y'all will be one, okay? Jesus Christ's Spirit will come and live inside of you, right? And then you go out into the world, you preach the gospel to those who are in darkness. If they decide to accept Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior, okay? And if they get baptized, guess what? The Holy Spirit comes and lives inside of them, and then guess what? And I understand that these are Power Ranger coins, though, but don't pay no attention to that. Just, you know, the glory, the golden, right? So they become new creatures in Christ Jesus with the Holy Spirit living inside of them. Amen? Okay? And then when they go out and preach the gospel, they go out and make disciples. Amen? So that when the Lord Jesus Christ comes back down from heaven, he comes to get the church and takes them. Okay? But that's not where it stops at. The Bible also says that on the day of judgment, it says that the righteous, okay? Oh, excuse me. Sorry about that, y'all. It said that the righteous are going to stand before the judgment seat of Christ, right? Now, let me tell you this. The judgment seat of Christ is for those, for the righteous, those who did right with the Lord, okay? Those who went out and did what the Lord Jesus Christ told them to do according to his word, right? Once Once the Lord Jesus Christ rewards the righteous, they all go and they go and live with Jesus Christ, right? In the new heavenly kingdom. Now, there's also a second death, right? There's also a second death, okay? When the sinful people, when they go and stand before God on the day of judgment, hold on. Once they are judged, see, this black mass represents sin, these people represent sin. Those people who rejected Jesus Christ, those people who were still in sin, right? They heard the gospel from God's people, right? But they still refused to listen. So they end up in sin, they end up dying in their sins, right? And their sins still on their life, right? So God will look at them on the day of judgment and say, "Depart from me, I never knew you, you cursed with everlasting fire, prepare for the devil and his angels." Okay? Since sin, wrap them up, and then they're thrown into the lake of fire for eternity. And then Jesus Christ creates a new heaven and a new earth where righteousness dwells. And Jesus Christ will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more sadness, there will be no more pain, no more death, for the former things are passed away. And that's the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So the question that remains is, which one would you be considered, a sheep or a goat? You choose, because Jesus Christ is coming soon. God bless.